Greetings, greetings everyone. My name is Elaine Ra, and I am happy to be here to bring a brand new podcast, and it is on the topic of the cover story. And what I mean by that is who we have created ourselves as being as a cover story to who we truly are. This is a really important subject, because as many of us are aware that we are more and more living in a world where the people, even people who we regard as family or close to us, there is quite often an identity that covers up their truth or who they truly are. And also perhaps how they're truly feeling about life, love and living, and even perhaps about you as a projection of how they are feeling and withholding within themselves. So a cover story often starts from childhood, when we are often not recognized or seen by our family or our parents or by people who are close to us. Or even if they see you, they tend to push that down and tell you you are not that, and try and encourage you to fit into a norm, a prototype identity that does not fit. It's like that metaphor of trying to fit a round peg into a square hole. It's never going to happen. And I think the world is really made up of all these people who have lost who they truly are and are showing up as their cover stories. That starts from a very fundamental level as a child, where we are molded into society's impression or idea of what it means to be human. And that is as far as how you look, how you express yourself, how you're allowed to express yourself, how you're able to talk about things that are truly important, and to gain popularity or to gain the love or attention of another person. So quite often what's really going on is put to the side, and what children end up putting forward is what they can create to get ahead. And of course there are also many children who are completely defiant in regard to trying to fit in or trying to be molded or in trying to be agreeable, which is really important that we allow ourselves to look and see what is really going on there. Rather than deem them as having behavioral problems or mental health issues or whatever, simply because they're saying, no, I want to be seen, I want to be recognized for who I truly am. So there's that, and there's also identities in terms of racial or ethnicity. You know, I'm a black person, I'm a white person, I'm Asian, and how that becomes a cover story, which, and once again, what I mean by cover story, it's covering up who you truly are beneath the colour of your skin, the colour of your eyes, how you speak, what language you speak. And these are all identities, you know. If you ask someone, so, who are you? Or, well, normally the first line of inquiry is, what do you do for a living? As if that is who you are. Of course it's not. Or then you're drawn to someone perhaps because of the colour of their skin, or not drawn to someone because of the colour of their skin or their gender or their sexuality. And this area in regard to who we identify ourselves as being, our gender, is a real deep-rooted fundamental program. You know, to be assigned a gender by birth requires us to behave in a particular way, which is also a cover story, because I think you're going to behave how you're naturally inclined to behave. Expressing feminine energy is not just something for women. You know, men are able to express feminine energy just the way women are able to express masculine energy, or to be dominant, or to be strong. So these are all cover stories that can enforce certain labels upon ourselves, and that includes certain behaviors. Now, we're also living in a world where there is so much projection of there being the enemy outside of ourselves, and how easy it is to assign that label of being the enemy to someone who may look like they represent that. And that could be a particular religion, or it could be a gender, what I call the gender agenda, right? I mean, they're all agendas anyway that are clearly showing up in the world now, whereby we are recognizing that to fit into the world, you have to represent by means of dressing in a particular way, by means of behaving in a certain way, by means of speaking in a certain way, using certain slang or whatever, having a particular swag, you know, that makes you more appealing. I mean, many young people spend years trying to finesse their swag, their swagger, or their, you know, their unique selling point, whereby they will feel more attractive or more acceptable in amongst their peers. For those that commute first thing in the morning on their way to work, and they see all the various, so many human beings who are dressed up in their suits or their uniforms, you know, and these are all cover stories, because of course we're not our profession. And I think it's great to be in a profession and to follow your heart, and to, you know, and to bring some kind of service into the world. But yet it seems that we're living in a world now where what people are really seeking is financial wealth in the form of currency. And we are living in a world where the current that is running this world, or the currency, is money. And I mean, there are other currencies. Sex is another currency, that, or sexuality. You use that to gain access into certain realms or into certain doorways, and that's often used. Even ethnicity, even though, you know, if you're living in a society where the majority of the people are Caucasian, for example, then, you know, maybe being a different ethnicity could be a positive thing, or it could be a negative thing. It really depends on how you're perceived, and of course how you perceive yourself, if you perceive yourself as that particular ethnicity. I think the focus on people wanting to get ahead in life, and that being and creating whatever means possible, you know, either working or doing whatever you need, you know, to become successful, can really jeopardize your sense of being or your sense of well-being. So many people in what I call high-powered jobs, whereby they are required to not listen to their inner tuition or their inner guidance or to abide by their own personal values. And slowly but surely, just because to be successful within that corporation, that has now become the standard that is required for them to measure themselves to. So their own personal standard, and we all have our own individual standard, and that's our sovereignty, that's our own golden standard, is sacrificed in pursuit of measuring up to this external requirement, be that through your corporation or the company that you work with, or the expectation that you may have adopted as what is required to be successful, or to be a human being that is one of the Joneses, so to speak, right? So these are all cover stories. I know on a personal level, you know, many years ago I was pursuing a career in the music industry, and I received two diagnoses, terminal actually, back in the day. And the second one really brought me to my knees. And I realized by that point that there was nowhere else to run, there was nowhere else to go. My back was against the wall. And there the journey outwards in terms of pursuing whatever I believed was outside of me, because in reality, when I would be trying to meet this place, trying to meet this place, the closer I went to it, it didn't necessarily get any closer. And I realized that if something is actually designed for you, you don't have to move towards it. If you carry on moving towards it, you're going against the current. You know, you need to go with the flow. And the symptoms and the signs will always be there. And if you're fortunate enough to even recognize these as symbols and signs that something is afoot and you need to really start paying attention to something, as in is beginning to tell you that how you're living your life is not really serving you ultimately, that there will be no ultimate reward. Cover stories come in a lot of guises, and the world is full of cover stories. All you have to do is to go to a newsagent and to look at all the magazines and to see all the various cover stories and the headshots of aspirational ideas and cover stories that are there for you to adopt. Be this, buy that, look at me, you know, and it's all drawing you outside of yourself. Headlines on newspapers, you know, these are all cover stories. The news, you know, the headlines and news bulletins. So many, the world is made up of all these cover stories that are calling you as a consumer. Come outside, come and consume this. This is what's going to make you happy. This is what's going to bring you fulfillment and contentment. Get this job, you get this job and you'll have this. You'll get this house and you'll get this money and you'll be more attractive to whoever, you know. And these are all cover stories that are constantly pulling you out, you know. The idea of fame and fortune, you know, but to what sacrifice? To what end will that bring, you know? Will that be the detriment of your own well-being, of your own health, of your own peace of mind? Even our emotions, allowing ourselves to identify to our emotions, even though our emotions and feelings are paramount for us to understand how we are experiencing life and what serves us or what's feeling good moment by moment. They're part of our guidance system. But then to anchor a feeling and emotion that then defines each moment in life, or an experience that then comes into your life and you define that, that is a cover story also, you know. That is a story that the unconscious has now been installed in the unconscious, that now defines who you are and our reality. In regards to being a human being or being an emotional being with feelings and being a soul being, how we define ourselves as that, and how we define ourselves as a spiritual being, these can also be cover stories. So once we take all of that off and we really strip everything down and expose and express the nakedness of the true essence of who resides within this body, who is looking from behind these eyes, right? Not what is outside of our eyes in terms of what we see and perceive and try and assimilate and try and imitate or try and create as our own persona, rather than allowing ourselves to sit deeply within ourselves, right? The journey in life is not an external one. It's not a point somewhere outside of us. It's a place within us that has never gone, has always been there. It's never been a destination. It's always there. And all that is truly required is for us to come and sit within the cradle or within the altar of our own being. And from there, everything is possible. And that is when and how we can be of true service in the world. And we can show up as we truly are. There's that wonderful metaphor about the onion, peeling back all the layers of the onion, and what you discover when you get to the core of that is what the quest is, which is everything and nothingness. You know, it is just the pure beingness, the witness of all that is untouched by our experiences and by our thoughts and by our identities. And, you know, one of the drawbacks of living a life that is in pursuit of these identities or these cover stories, that it creates a contraction within you. It creates distortions, and this manifests as fear, disease, powerlessness, unworthiness, needing to fit in, competition, all these things that bring separation. And one of the cover stories that is quite prevalent now in the world is that of the terrorist. But in truth, the terrorist is just simply an aspect that has now become part of the human condition that all of us live within, which is a distorted version of the lover, you know, that has not been embraced and accepted and attended to, you know, the true soul, spirit being that we are, you know, the God self that has been hijacked or put aside for just a facsimile of some other version of ourselves that we believe ourselves to be. And the terrorist is a version of that. It taps into that part of us that is fear-driven, has been terrorized simply by virtue of abandoning the true essence of who we are. So these are all false projections based upon our cover stories, the ideas of the world, and the identities that so many people are playing out, which has caused these distortions of self, which have ended up covering and coverting with the negative aspects of life, love, and living. And if we allow ourselves to recognize them for what they are and to awaken ourselves in service of our true salvation, in service of our own homecoming and healing and awakening, then everything is there to serve us. And we can receive the medicine and the higher learnings that are there in that experiencing. Please remember, it is nobody's business who you are. It is your business to discover who you truly are. And as you awaken and step out of the matrix and step out of the boxes that you have found yourself in, to step out of the identities and the roles and the models that never really quite fitted anyway, to realize that when you're living within a society that looks for the norms, people tend to compare themselves amongst themselves and try and embellish that even more so you can stand out. Just by virtue of releasing all of that, you will begin to shine from the inside out like a firefly, and you begin to radiate. And people may perceive that as even being a cover story, because they're not going to quite understand what is going on. But that's okay. They may perceive that as some kind of cover story. But that is unimportant to you. All you need to do is to just really allow the essence that you have discovered from within you to exude its fragrance, just like a flower exuding its fragrance. It does not need to ask permission to do so. It's what it does naturally. And this is what we are all designed to do, which is just to exude the perfume of the divine from within us, the true essence of who we truly are. So what is the meaning of life? Why are we here? Who are we really? Who is observing from behind these eyes? When we go to bed at night, that person who begins to relax and to fall asleep is essentially the closest who we can get to who we are when we are with ourselves. That person that wakes up first thing in the morning and opens your eyes and you really get a sense of who you are and how you're relating to the quantum field or to existence. And when the thoughts start arising and start coming into your vortex or your vibrational vortex, be that things like work or the various things that you have to do, and before we know it, we start stepping into these identities or these cover stories. And I think it's so important these days for us to recognize that these aren't truly who we are, and of course we have to function, and of course we have to look after ourselves and our children and to put food on the table. But to what expense and to what extent do we leave the altar of our being to manufacture this other identity or to reinstate or to endorse this identity, which we end up projecting by virtue of our own behavior onto one another, our children and the world around us? It is really important at this time that we really recognize that our own healing and our own salvation and our own truth, that our own homecoming, our own awakening, coming home to oneself, is no different to coming home to God, to your God self, to your true self, to your authentic self, that self that is naked, that is open, that is allowing, that is not attempting to masquerade as anything or anyone else. And this is the only destination, if it is a destination, which is to come home to self. And this is an awakening into the truth of who we are. And not to be afraid of any rude awakenings, what I call rude awakenings, which often come from having gone so far away from self that then something happens in the form of an accident or a diagnosis or an estrangement or whatever it may be that awakens you in a way that really shakes you up. Everything is medicine. Everything is by design for us to come home to ourselves. Don't leave it. Don't wait for yourself. Come home to yourself. Recognize that the most important journey in life is coming home to you, so you can truly experience life from the inside out, where you can experience joy and love moment by moment, and compassion and trust. And all these words, these are all words and ideas, but they are all to come into yourself, to love yourself, to trust that all is perfect, whole, and complete, just as it is, without you having to do anything. This is how it is, and this is the journey, to be aware of the cover stories that we have set upon ourselves or society has encouraged us to emulate or to embody, which of course manufacture so many subtexts and other stories and dramas that so many people play out as their reality, unfortunately. So I leave this with you. You are perfect, whole, and complete. Dare to be truly who you are. Dare to begin to take down the masks, to reveal the truth of your existence, to reveal the truth of that immaculate being that exists within you, that is eternal, that never dies, that was never born. That part of you that links all of life, love and living to all of life, love and living in its true essence, in its true beingness. I love you. I see the God in you. Be well. Walk in beauty. Sit within the altar of your being and know this to be true. My name is Elaine Ra. Until the next time, I love you. Namaste.